Welcome back everyone. So this will be the tutorial and explanation for my 6x6 piston door that I showed you for my subscriber special the other day. So in case you haven't seen it yet, I will just show you how it looks. So it closes like this and it opens like this, and as you can see, it's super fast for its size. And yeah, so if you're interested in making this, I will now show you how to build this. Alright, so to build this door you will need the following materials. I will just scroll down the material list right now and you can take a screenshot or pause the video. Okay, so and additionally you will need a few items to put into the furnaces, into the droppers and into the hoppers, but we will get to those later and it can be junk items, so yeah. Okay, so for this door you will need a 5x16 area and the door will be 17 blocks tall, and we will start by placing in the door frame. And for this we go to one edge and go to the center and we count 5 blocks like this, 5 blocks like this, and then one more block, and that will be the edge of your door frame, and we can just fill that in right now. So 6 blocks on each side obviously, and now we can start by building the layout. Okay, so this layout originally was made by Dutt Cookie Dough, but I modified it a little bit for my version of the store. And yeah, so for the bottom we start by placing a triple here and then 3 more next to it, and then 4 singles and some blocks. This will be our bottom hipsters, and we will have the same thing on top. So 4 triples, and then our storage blocks, storage pistons and the storage blocks. And for the sides we'll place a single here, a double here, another single and a triple, and now we just mirror it basically like this. And we'll also need a triple here and a triple here. We can just fill in these 2 blocks. And now we do the same thing on the other side. So just mirror the pattern and we are done. And because this is a little bit more involved than my other doors, I will just show you how this works. So for the closing we extend this, and then also the corner triple and the bottom hipsters. And lastly we extend this, and we have 1/4. And then for the opening, first we retract this, we extend this, grab this block, and then these blocks basically get grabbed, and then the triple extends out of the wall and grabs that final block, and then this just retracts. And while that's happening we just retract the bottom hipsters like this. I just grab the last block, and this is how that works. Okay, but because we need to actually power this piston when it's here and these 2 pistons when they are here, we need to place some extra things to power them. So we will go to the side with storage pistons and place 2 normal pistons like this and 2 like this, a glass block here and an observer on each side pointing into the wall. And then on top you will also have 2 normal pistons facing down again next to these storage pistons, and just fill in the wall. I will use glass for this tutorial, but obviously you want to use a solid block probably. And then to power these pistons we'll actually use an observer, which we will push and pull out of the wall basically, and we place this right here next to the single. And to push it down we have 3 normal pistons like this. You can just fill in this, and to push them back up you will need three more pistons like this on each side. And now all that's left is piston like this and like this to actually push the observer out of the wall. And we will also need these pistons for later. I will explain what they do. But yeah, for now we just place them. And this should be your layout. And now we will start with the input circuit. Okay, so below your four storage pistons, you will place four blocks at the bottom. And then two more like this, and your input will be right here. Then you place a slab here, and an observer pointing into it. And dust on top. Now we place some instant repeaters, so a block here. Two observers like this, pistons like this, a redstone block, and update the bottom one. And the same thing on this side. Then you place a node block like this. Block up. Slab here. Another block here. And then we just place slabs and go upwards. Like this. And then into an observer here. And then two blocks like this. And then basically the same thing on the other side. So two blocks here. We don't need the node block on this side. Slab, another block. More slabs like this. Then we just go up into an observer. Right here. And then two blocks like this, actually also two blocks like this. Then we take a block here, and then observer pointing downwards. Two-tick repeater on top, another slab into a sticky piston with a block, another slab, two blocks, slab, node block, and then we can just extend this ceiling. Another node block, and then a final slab here. So just break and replace this observer. And the top part should be done. And on the bottom, we come to this side first and place three blocks like this. We go down a block, place three observers like so. Two slabs and then just some blocks. I like to use another color for the actual circuitry, so I'll use the light blue terracotta here. And on this side, two blocks like this, an observer here, a block, slab, and a block, two observers, and another block, and then a repeater here and a repeater here. And now we can just start placing dust everywhere, like so, and also on this side, like this. And now just on top, and I can just give it a quick test if everything turns on. So this looks good so far. Yeah, so that's the input circuit done. So we just fix this real quick, and now we can move on to the actual wiring of the door. And we'll start with the sides closing and also some parts of the sides opening. Alright, so first we come here and place a block and a node block. And a two-tick repeater pointing into it, another node block, and another block, and dust here. Place two slabs like this, two blocks like this, a four-tick repeater and dust. And this is just a standard 042 pattern for double extenders, and we just add the single dust here so it starts closing instantly. Then we come down below, place a node block here, a dropper with any item inside. Then a furnace below it with a different item in the top slot, and this will silence the dropper. Place an obsidian here, and an observer pointing into the obsidian. And so this hopper will get bothered by this node block and updated by this one. And this will actually power the triple on the opening so that this piston gets pushed here. Okay, so to continue, we place a 4 tick here and a 1 tick here. And this will retract this block, so that this piston can grab this block here, the opening. Then all we need to do on this side is place two observers like this to power the first slider, and to power the second one, place one behind this vortex into a block, which will butt power the piston and just not block to update it. And now all that's left is we need to power the single extender. And to do this, we place three observers like this and node block like this. Okay, so the other side is fairly similar. So a block, a furnace, into a 2-tick repeater. Sorry, a block and a node block. And then just two blocks dust. And now we need an observer pointing downwards. Another one like this, and then the slab and the block. Place dust in our 40 repeater. And now we place our node block and the dropper and the furnace, our immovable block and the observer, our repeaters, and then just like before, two observers like this, another one like this, and the block and the node block here. And now we just need the three servers like this into a node block. Okay, so this will send the blocks like this, and they will get pushed up by the triples and by the hipsters. And for the final two blocks closing, we just place observer like this and a block here, and the same thing on this side. Okay, so now we move on to these extenders. So, two observers like this, and a block here, and dust on top. Then again, our 0, 4, 2 pattern, and block here. Place another block just above it with dust, and then two slabs and a block. Dust on the first one, and then a 1-tick repeater and a 4-tick repeater, and a hopper right here, and this has to be a hopper. Okay, now we come out from this block and put an observer below, 2-tick repeater, and then two more observers with the block. And this will butt power the single for the retraction. And this will, on the closing, put this piston here. The opening will be pulled up again so it can actually push out the observer. Alright, so same thing on this side. Observers and a block, dust on top. And three more blocks, our 042 pattern. Then we already placed this earlier, so we need just two observers and the block. Now we place our slabs, block and the hopper, and our repeaters with the dust. And if you might have noticed, we placed this earlier, but this makes it so the triple actually ends up like this, but we want it like this. So we need to add one more pulse to the back. And the way we do that is we come out from this block here with the vortex. There's another one here, which we get powered by this block, which is powered by the dust. And then we place a block here, slab here, and two observers like this, vortex on top of this one, dust here. Then we just place a sticky piston and an observer here, which will power these so the triples are in the right configuration, and on the opening we can actually use this when it comes back for the triple retraction. Okay, so the same thing on this side, vortex here to block, slab, two observers, our vortex and the dust, and then just our piston here with an observer. And this is actually it for the sides closing, and now we can move on to the hipsters closing. And we'll start by placing some inputs for the hipsters. So on the bottom, we place an observer like this. Four blocks and then rails on top, either powered or activated rails. Then observers on top and blocks on top. Then we take some glass or any other block that's movable. And two normal pistons like this. And observers on top. So when you flick the lever, this will trigger the observers. Then we come back here, and let me just break this so we can actually place stuff. And we will place four observers right here, glass in front of them, and the piston here, and then we place blocks behind the observers. And on top of those, we place more observers, which will all be used later, like this, and we can have our inputs on top. And for these, we just place two observers pointing up, then two pointing outwards, and our repeaters on top. And that's for the inputs for the bottom ones. Now on top, we place blocks like this, and actually an observer here. Then dust on top, repeaters in the middle, and comparators on the outside. And I will explain why later. And now for these pistons, we also use a slider. So piston here, five blocks like this. Another piston here, and then observers pointing downwards into these pistons. And next to the observers, place a dust line like this. Another block here without dust, and then an updater piston in the middle. Alright, so to actually close this, this will get powered, and these will push the blocks inside. So now all we need to do is just power this line. And we do it by placing two observers like this. And then a 1-tick and a 2-tick repeater. And this will also close the back pistons of the corner triples on top. And for this one, we just place two observers like this. And then a 3-tick. And because we already placed this earlier, this is actually it for the top closing. Now to move on to the bottom. Again, we already have this, and we already have these three, these repeaters here to power the bottom pistons. So now all that's left is to power these ones. And because we actually need to delay them a bit, we block this line, and then we uncut the line to power it. So place a piston here, block here, and coming out from this node block that we placed in the beginning, place an observer, block, and then a node block to update it. And now all that's left for the closing is to power these pistons here. And to do this, we come in here and place a block right here. Repeat on 2 ticks. An observer pointing upwards with a dust. And then two more blocks like this. And then another repeat on 1 tick here. And we do the same thing on this side. So a block here, 2 tick repeater, an observer with dust. Actually, we need to move this one over. So block here with the repeater, observer, dust, two more blocks, and then our final repeater on 1 tick. And that should be the entire closing, and we can move on to the opening. All right, so the first thing that needs to happen in the opening is the sliders need to start extending, and we actually need that instantly. And the way we do that is we place a block here with a repeater on 1 tick and then a piston here. So what will happen is that during the closing, this piston will still be extended, and then we power this. But since this is already extended, it can't push. Then later this will unpower, and this piston actually hasn't realized that it can push. So on the opening, this will turn off, the piston will reject instantly, but this will still be on for 1 tick, so that it actually starts extending instantly. And that's how we get the slider to start moving as soon as possible. Alright, so we actually need an observer below this with a block and a node block, our repeater block, and also place this back. Then the same thing on this side. Observer with a repeater to a block into a node block, and then just our normal piston right here. And then we also need to push the slider back up. So first we place two observers like this, and we place two repeaters on 4 ticks on top. Then we take a sticky piston to place right here with an observer, block below, repeat on 4 ticks. Now we use a dropper and a hopper with an item inside. We use the dropper because it can be buzzed by this observer, and the hopper is just to silence it. Then, coming out of the dropper, we place an observer powering the first piston, another one pointing up with a block for the second one, and now we place a normal piston right here. We need a cauldron and some water. Place the cauldron here, water inside, then block here, and a comparator on top. And just power this real quick. And we also need to push it down. So we place a glass on top or another block, and a piston here. And then a block here, tooting repeater, knobs pointing into the piston. Alright, now we just copy it to this side. So, oops, so that was like this. Two vortex repeaters on top. A sticky piston, an observer, block with the vortex, then our dropper hopper circuit, and now just two observers like this, two into a block, and now we just place the cauldron and water thing again. And by the way, make sure you do not shift click or you will have a bad time. And cauldron, just push this up, block, another piston, and then our two tick and our observer. So we also need to keep these pistons here extended during the closing so that these don't push up while we close the door. So coming out from this dust that's on this block, place two observers, place a sticky piston here, another cauldron with water, and then blocks like this, dust here, comparator, and a 3D vortex repeater, and the same thing on this side. So two observers into the piston, two blocks here, dust, comparator, 3-tick and a 4-tick. So this will be extended during the closing for a little bit, and then unpower, and then on the opening these will be allowed to push up, and then it will just push them back down. Okay, so now we can move on to the actual opening circuits for the hipsters, I guess. And we will start with the bottom. So we come to the back and to the left corner, place an observer, 40 repeater on top, and then four observers going into this piston. Then on this side, you place three observers coming out of the piston like this, and then a block here, another block here, two repeaters on two ticks each, and we just break this for now. Place an observer like this, and we go in here, place another one here, and now we need a lamp, which we place like here, and then another observer here. We can replace the dust. And now we come here, place a block with dust, two repeaters and four ticks, into a block, and a slab below with dust. And we actually need to redirect the dust so it doesn't power the piston. An observer next to it, just break this for now. Three tick repeater on top, and we can replace it. And on this side we do something very similar, but this time we place some observers like this first, then oops, make sure this is on two ticks, and also push this back up like this. So our dust, 4-tick repeater, and now we need some scaffolding in a trapdoor, which we place like this, our 4-tick and the block on top. And then three more observers like this. And the reason we have a scaffolding here is that it will give us a 1 game pick delay. And this is the pulse which powers the pistons through the storage blocks when they are here. And this delay is needed so that the side triplets don't get messed up, basically. And now all that's left for the hipsters is to come to the front side, the left, and coming out of this observer, there's another one like this, a piston here, into another observer, another piston, and then one final observer. And now coming out from the node block, we just place observers like this, and two more like this, and we can just put these blocks back here, and that should be it for the hipsters. And now we can move on to the triple extenders. Okay, so next to this block that's higher than these two, we come inside and place an observer pointing downwards like this, another one like this, repeater on vortex on top, then coming out of this observer, place a block with a 2-tick repeater and another observer pointing this way. Now from this piston, place observers like this and like this into a hopper, then the observer into a block with dust, and then we take a chest or anything else to redirect the dust so it points this way. And now the same thing on the other side. So we come out from this observer, piston, observer, and two observers. Then we go in here and place our two observers like this. Four-tick repeater, block with a 2-tick. And now our observer, the hopper, another observer, block with dust and redirect it. And we're almost done with the bottom. All that's left now is to place a hopper right next to this observer coming out, another observer into a block. And we do the same thing on this side. And that should be it for the bottom opening, and we can move on to the top. Okay, one more thing we need to do is to control this slider. So coming out from this observer right here, place one pointing downwards with a 2-tick on top, just replace this, and then place another one like this, which will power the piston. And on this side, we place more observers like this, and we actually place another piston here. So on the closing, this piston will push, and then obviously retract when we open again. But on the opening, this will actually be part of the slider itself, which is pretty cool. And then we just place one final observer right here, and now we are done with the bottom. Okay, so for the top, we start by placing some inputs for these corner triples. So just break these two blocks for now, and place an observer like this, and a piston here, and then just replace everything. And we will do the same thing on this side. So observer right here, replace this, and then place a piston like this down below this block and replace the other piston. Okay, so for the actual wiring, place a torch right here and then a hopper timer below. So two hoppers pointing into each other, and then place four items into the left hopper. Okay, then next to this vortex repeater, we place a block with a torch and then a piston next to it. And now we place observers like this, going into this dust line. And now we take a sticky piston, which you place here, an observer next to it. All right, so for now, we just place an observer here and a 3-tick repeater on top, another observer like this, block below, then a hopper, and you break this dust for now, and another observer, and two repeaters on one tick. Now we extend this repeater line with a 4-tick like this, place an observer here, into a hopper, into another hopper, and then one last observer like this pointing into this piston. Then coming out from the hopper timer, we place a comparator like this, one final observer here, and then an all piston here, which will give us a double pulse. And now we can just replace this dust. And for this side, all that's left is to place a piston here into a hopper, and then three observers pointing into the dust, sorry, place the observer here, not a piston. And then from this torch, place a vortex repeater into an observer into a block, which will power this again. And now coming out from this cauldron, place two observers and a block right here. And now just an observer coming out of the observer, of the comparator into this dust line. Alright, so on this side, you also place a torch. Then an observer pointing to the left, right next to it. The repeater and vortex on top. Then observer here, two blocks, and a 3-tick repeater. And this is also the reason we use comparators here, and not just repeaters everywhere, because this way we can actually differentiate between the corner triples and the hipster triples, because the observers will only, the comparators will only react to the 3-tick pulses and not to the 1-tick pulses, so this way we can have just one line to control both, basically. Alright, so to finish this, place another piston here, and hopper with dust, another observer, another piston, then one observer pointing into this piston we placed earlier. Next to the torch, place a block and a slab. Slab is because we still need the dust to go up. Then two repeaters and vortex. And two observers and a block to power this dust again. And now all that's left for the top is to place two observers here. And one observer here with a 3-tick repeater. Replace this. And now place two solid blocks here and any block behind and dust on top. And this is for the second block retraction of the corner triples. And this should actually be it for the top. Alright, so we're actually almost done. All that's left now is the side triple extension and retraction. So to do this, we start off by placing a block right next to this one with dust and a comparator behind it. And then a dropper hopper monostable like this with a block inside. Then we come here and place a block with a 2-tick repeater on top, and two blocks like this, a piston like this, and then one observer pointing into this out of the 2-tick repeater. Alright, now because it's easier to reach, we place a hopper here with dust, and then two observers like this into another dust, which will be for the retraction. And then just place a block here and a repeater like this, just to redirect this dust. And now we need another dropper hopper monostable to power this piston to push out the observer. So we come here, place our observer with dust. Then our dropper hopper circuit like this. And then a comparator came out of this. And this will actually redirect the dust as well, which is just what we need here, so that this piston doesn't get messed up. And then just piston here with a block. So yeah, this will actually get powered pretty early during the closing, so we don't want to mess up anything, so we basically extend this after this first time. Alright, so now all that's left is the final block retraction, and for this we place a slab here with dust, then a repeater into a sticky piston, another observer here into a block. So this observer will actually detect the side being moved, and this way we move this observer back and forth, and then a second time it gets a pulse here, which will be our final retraction. Alright, so we do the same on this side, block here, dust, comparator, our monostable, then block here, the 2-tick, and our observer, block here. You already have this block here, sticky piston. Then down below, place our hopper with dust, two observers, another dust. Then our block and the repeater. And again, observer, dust, and then the DH monostable, like this. And now we place this, and all that's left is the final retraction on this side. So, slab like this with dust, observer, piston, observer, and block. And that should be the door. So, let's just test it right now. And hopefully, I didn't make any mistakes and it works first time. Alright, so I actually did make a few mistakes. So, let's just fix that real quick. So, first, you need to place a block right here. And you also need to place solid blocks in the wall right here and right here to power the slider when it comes down. So this will still be powered when the pistons arrive, so we basically get the final pulse, final extension. And then on the bottom you need to add this piston right here. And now you should have everything for the store. So let's actually test it right now. It closes. And it also opens. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. It was quite long, but anyways, I hope it was worth it for you, and thank you for watching.